Okay, this question has come up with pretty much every client this year, and that is, how do we get started with automation? Notion's made it a lot easier to set up automations internally without the need for third-party tools, but there's so much we could do when we use tools like Relay to connect Notion to other tools that we're using on a regular basis. And most importantly, remove those manual repetitive tasks that don't require a lot of skill, but do require a lot of time. Out of all the possible automations out there, focusing on meetings has been both one of the easiest automations to implement and has been the most transformative when we factor in creating a Notion page when a calendar invite is created and getting into AI note takers and bringing that information to Notion and even automatically populating tasks from those notes. We're going to be breaking this up into two parts. So this video is solely on setting up an automation so that when we create an event in Google Calendar, we're creating a page in a meetings database in Notion and looking at a few additional customizations that we might want to make, specifically how to tag contacts in our contacts database if their email shows up in the calendar event. And in the next video, we're taking it a step further and looking at how we can incorporate Fireflies, an AI note-taking tool, to automatically summarize meetings, bring those summaries back into Notion, and most importantly, extract those tasks and action items from the meeting notes and bring those into our task database. So if you don't want to miss that, definitely subscribe so you can see it as soon as it goes live. If you're new here, I'm Dave DeCespedes. I'm a certified Notion consultant, and I've worked with teams on everything from migrating to Notion, building workspaces, setting up automations, usually all of the above. So if you're interested in everything Notion and productivity, definitely subscribe to the channel. Okay, before we set up our automation in Relay, a couple databases that we're going to be referencing in Notion. The first is a meetings database. So this is tracking standard meeting notes. Summary, this is in our part 2 video, which we'll get into later. But things like if a meeting is tied to contacts, we're going to set that up automatically in this automation. And other notes, like if we're tracking the video conferencing URL or the calendar event URL, things like that, in addition to kind of setting up our standard meeting notes. The second database is a contacts database. So this is actually using a tool called Clay. And one really nice thing is its integration and kind of a two-way sync between Clay and a Notion database that once you set up the connection, it's kind of syncing your contacts into a Notion database. Really great and super useful, especially if you're tagging contacts in projects or meetings, pretty much exactly what we're doing here. You don't have to use Clay. This works with your own contacts database if you have that. But these are the two primary databases in Notion that we're referencing. The other area is obviously a Google Calendar. So we're going to set up a brand new event to test this automation. So we're connecting Google Calendar to Notion using Relay. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to click on create a new workflow, and we're going to call this Google Calendar to Notion meetings. And once we've got that named, we're going to add a trigger, and we're going to look for Google Calendar here. We're going to set this to when an event is scheduled. So select that one. From here, we're going to add a calendar. If you have multiple calendars that you're subscribed to, you want to make sure we have the right one. In this case, we're looking for Notion demo. Let's just try typing in demo. So we've got that calendar. And from here, you do have the option to set up an additional filter. For example, if it's titled a certain way or if there are certain attendees that are going. One that I like to use is if a video link is not empty, meaning if it's an event that has a Zoom link or a Google Meet link, then send it to Notion, just factoring in if we're blocking out times on our calendar or if we've got personal things in there that are not technically meetings, you won't pull those into Notion. So do have that option. We'll leave that one on for this demo. And we don't have any examples yet because it's a brand new calendar. So we're going to click done. The next step we're going to do is in Notion, we're going to add page to our meetings database. So we're going to search for meetings. Going to select our first entry. And from here, we want to decide what we want to populate in Notion, whether that's the video conferencing link, attendees, things like that. So first, for the content, this is what lives in the body of the page. For data, we're going to grab the summary, I think it's the description. So we're gonna have that populate in the body of the page. Next, for fields to populate, first one is we're gonna grab the date, and we're gonna grab both the start and end date from Google Calendar. So we're gonna add start, save, do the same thing for end, save. So whatever start and end time is in Google Calendar, it's gonna show in Notion's meetings database. Next thing we're gonna add is the title. That's an important one. So the name of the page that's getting added in Notion is going to be the title of the event. And the last thing we wanna bring into Notion is if there is a video conferencing link, we're going to fill in the Zoom URL property, and we're gonna look for the video conferencing link from Google Calendar. Actually, while we're here, let's also grab the Google Calendar event link. Let's drop that in also. If you are video conferencing, if you're using Google Meet or Zoom or a combination of things, you could probably just call it video conferencing in Notion as a property. In my case, I'm primarily using Zoom, so it's called Zoom URL. So let's click done and let's test this first version of the automation just to make sure that it's working. We're gonna turn this on and we're gonna head back to Google Calendar. We're going to add an event here. Let's add it for the 23rd at 1 p.m. And we'll make sure that this is part of the Notion demo calendar so that that's the one that's part of the automation. We're gonna click save. And actually, let's add a Zoom link here also. So we've got our Zoom link, we've added a team member, added time, start and end time, and name. So we've got our event. And if we head back into Relay, let's go ahead and test this out. So in our menu, we're gonna click start a test run. And we'll see here that the new event is showing up. So let's go ahead and test this out. So back in our automation, if we head to our menu, we're gonna select start a test run, and we're gonna select the new calendar event that we just created. And when we click create test run, we're gonna get this menu, confirm our two steps for part of this automation. And then when we select start run, this is gonna show us confirmation, or if there's any errors, it's gonna pull up where those errors are. So it looks like this ran. If I go back to meetings, I can now see that we've got our new meeting page in Notion, and we can see it pulled in the start and end date. It pulled in both the Zoom URL and the calendar URL. And that's about it. It didn't have any description in the event, so this is empty. So pretty basic, but we're gonna go a few steps further. The first thing we're gonna look at is if you manage contacts in Notion, we're gonna use the email addresses based on who's invited to the event and search your contacts database. And if there's a result or if there's a match, go ahead and link those contacts to your meeting page. So back in our automation, we're gonna turn this off so that we can add a few additional steps. The next thing we're gonna add is using Relay's iterator tool. This is for automations where it's parsing a list or maybe has several steps where we're reviewing bullet points or reviewing, in this case, a list of email addresses. We wanna make sure that it runs the automation for each item on that list. So we're looking for email addresses, searching our contacts database to see if any of those emails come up. And then if they do, adding those contacts to our meeting page. So for this step, we're gonna look in the Google Calendar event and then specifically guests. So this is pulling the list of attendees. So we'll click done. And then within this iterator step, we're going to search our contacts database. So here we're going to select find pages and we're gonna search our contacts, shows up here. So for this step, we want to return matches in a list. So just considering if we have an event that has multiple attendees, we wanna make sure we grab all of the attendees. And the filter we're using is specifically their email address. So if I look for primary email, which is a property in our Notion contacts database, if there is a page that matches our iterator step, this is the email from this current step in the automation, then we'll use this to add those contacts to our meeting page. In terms of behavior, you have the option to continue if we don't find any matches, or if it's critical that you do add those contacts into the meeting page, you can set it to fail so that the automation won't continue running unless it finds matches in your contacts database. We're gonna set this to continue and select done. And from here, we're gonna add one more step, which is If there is a match, we're going to connect that contact to your meeting page. So from here, we're going to add one more step. And specifically, we want to connect any contacts that show up to that original meeting page. So if we search for Notion, we're going to update page. And the pages that we're updating are the contacts that we found in the previous step, in that iterator step, which is searching via their email address from the Google Calendar event to pull up those contacts from our database. So here we're going to look for first result in this page. And again, because it's an iterator, even if there's multiple entries, it will run for every attendee for this event. So once we have the contacts selected, now we're going to populate the meetings relation in our contacts database back to the original meeting, which is step two. So to back up, we create an event in Google Calendar that gets sent to a Notion meetings database as a new page. Based on the attendees' emails, we're searching our contacts database, and then lastly, connecting those contacts to the meeting page that we just created, just so that we could, say, search meetings by specific attendees or see when and where we connected or met with contacts in our contacts database. So we're gonna click done here. Before we run our new version of the automation, we're gonna create a new event in our Google Calendar. So we're gonna say at 10 a.m., call this Notion Automation 2.0. I'm gonna add a few guests here, add a Zoom link, and we're gonna add a description. So we have everything we need. It's 10 to 11 a.m. We're gonna click save and send. So now back in Relay, we're going to start a test run, look for new entries. So we can see here, we've got that one for the 26th. We'll select that one to run and then click create test run, start test run. And this will just kind of walk us through to make sure that everything succeeds or if there's any errors. So it looks like everything went well. And if I go back to meetings, we can see here, we've got our new meeting page in Notion. And if I open this up, we could see if it pulled in any contacts. So it pulled in my contact and it pulled in the Zoom link, the calendar link. So this opens up the event in Google Calendar. And if I go down to the bottom, it also grabbed the description. And then last thing, if we open our contact page, so this is the contact that's getting connected to the meeting. We can also see that the meeting is accessible here. So in scenarios where you want to open your contacts database and see which previous meetings they attended, you can also do that from your contacts database. So that's just a quick look on how to set up an automation that creates a meeting page in Notion when an event is created in Google Calendar, and then looking at how to tag contacts if you're managing your contacts in Notion. And one last reminder, we're going one step further in part two of this video, where we're incorporating Fireflies to generate meeting summaries automatically using AI. And most importantly, extract those tasks and action items from the meeting notes and bring those into our task database. Very excited about that one. It's something that I've been using personally and has been a game changer for just keeping track of all of the action items across many different meetings that happen over the course of a week. So definitely subscribe if you want to check that out. And if you've got questions on what we covered, drop those in the comments. Otherwise, see you in the next video.